Have a look in awe at Ruler doing a bunch of damage. No, we in fact have this highlight.
Yeah.
And this was where Beryl threw everything away into the wall. And,
yeah.
Just got obliterated.
After such a great start. And then, you know, we saw Showmaker was just so nullified in this game by Clid and BDD. And it was a really fun game to watch of BDD on this Azir because, sure, he's playing a really favorable matchup, but at the same time, it did feel like redemption, as you said in the cast, after that series against T1 last week, that lane matchup against Faker, where he was the first player to lose to Seraphine on the Azir this season and in career, of course, in LCK because she just came out. But, you know, the other thing, too, is you mentioned, Atlas, like, Dom1 and Kia weren't playing for anything but the winning streak, but when you are number one seed guaranteed, no matter what, like, what else do you have to play for? Like, if you can actually set the world record, like, or the LCK record, not why we're talking about that.
Yeah.
You could set the top record for win streaks in the regular season. Like, maybe no one will ever be able to top of that again. When 2015 SK Telecom did it, no one's been able to stop it since then. Like, that's permanent, right? So I think you really care about the series. I think if anyone suggests that Dom1 Kia didn't take this series seriously because...
Oh, absolutely not. Yeah, no, I agree.
Like, if you're like, well, Beryl was kind of messing up, I think he was just messing around. No, I don't think so. Like, he had an uncharacteristically weak series, but... Gen G drafted well, they came prepared for strategy. Gen G treated this series like it was their most important series they have left, and it was the hardest series for them to win of the matchups they have left in the season, so, you know, chances they take second after this upset win are pretty good.
Yeah, it's almost guaranteed at this stage. Of course, Humble Life can theoretically do it, I believe, based on Gen G losing their series after this, but that's not looking likely with how well they're playing, and some of the nameplates as well. Of their next few matchups. It does make things super interesting for the playoffs as well as we go forward, because the likelihood that a Gen G in second place faces off against T1 in the semi-final or playoff round two is very, very high.
Yeah, it's really high too. And the other thing about this, Alice, is this is the game we're going to be referencing on those playoff casts, right?
Absolutely.
This series.
I mean, this is the night and day, right? The T1 series, that's the low light of Gen G, but this is 100% the highlight.
Yeah.
This is Ruler getting a quadra kill and then actually killing the Nexus instead. That's how mad he was.
I like how Clid also dodged it. He was like, whoa. And you know, the crazy thing about this too is that Dom1 Kia also, I feel like, underestimated Gen G in this series based on their drafts. They didn't see this one coming.